I think one of the biggest mistakes that anyone can make is assuming you are not worthy of a cyber attack. We all are. It doesn't mean that you have to live in a big mansion or have all of these fancy things. What if an attacker is practicing on you? What if someone drives into your neighborhood and just circles to see if they can hit your Wi-Fi network? What if they're trying to breach your security and just get in? And we have so many smart things in our home, and you can see these are actually some of mine. I also have Nest cameras. I have all kinds of things that could be hacked if you think about it. You have smart dishwashers, refrigerators, washing machines. Some homes are even built to be completely smart and electronic, where you can turn on all your lights. You can talk through your doorbells. It's insane what we can do, but we need to make sure we're smart about it. I have so many friends that come in here and they say, Heather, based upon what you do, why do you have an Alexa? Why is Sonos playing music all over your house right now from your device? And it's because I learned to trust it. I know how to secure them. I know to set passcodes. And I just make sure that I'm also aware anyone can be attacked. You just have to be really, really smart and educated about what you use and how you use it. One of the easiest ways to keep all these devices secure, and most of these you will see will function off your home Wi-Fi. So here I have an Amplify, and it's a mesh network that connects through my house. Set a passcode. Make sure it's not admin and password 1234. When Verizon or your network service provider comes into your home and sets up your internet, the admin password, anyone can Google that and find that. They can look on the back of your box and see what it actually is. You need to change that. And you should also change the name of your Wi-Fi. So set a smart password. You can also set up guest accounts. So if you came into my home, I could share a temporary password with you so that if you came back later, you would not be connected to my internet. So I think things just like controlling that then keeps my Alexa safer, keeps my Google Home, my Apple TV, because everything is the strength behind your Wi-Fi. So you want to make sure you're really controlling that. When you have new Wi-Fi set up, or even you switch services, or you just moved locations, you should ask the technician while they're there to show you how to log in and change your password. That is exactly what you want to do. Leverage them. They're there. They're experts on this to help you. If not, reference your SANS cheat sheets and everything we're providing to you to just make you more educated on how to do it. If you Google it, it will tell you. You could say, I have Verizon, I use their router, or I have Amplify. How do I change my password? You can find it all through Google. It's so simple to do, but be smart about it. I don't want to call this Mahalik Wi-Fi and the passwords being Heather Mahalik's Wi-Fi. So you want to make sure that it makes sense to you and your family can remember it, but also it doesn't make sense to everyone. Technology is not going away. So we have to learn to adapt, adjust, and become one with it. And you can say all you want that you're going to stop using technology and you're not going to make your home a smart home and you're not going to have any of these devices, but it's becoming impossible. We are living with them. We are living for them. We are connecting to them. We're in our cars. There's Wi-Fi in our cars. So right now in my home, you could have my car Wi-Fi in my garage and my home Wi-Fi right here. So we just need to be smart about it. We need to think about every trace we leave behind, how to protect ourselves, and honestly, treat these devices like your wallet. You protect your wallet. You don't want people getting your credit cards and getting access to everything. You should be protecting your passwords the same way like that. So you really just have to educate yourself and don't be afraid of it. I couldn't live without these things. It's my world. It's my work. It's my kids' world, my kids' school. Everything relies on technology. So don't fear it, embrace it, and be smart about it.